Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture series on R microcontroller. So this is the continuation of the instruction videos. So here I have considered few more categories or few more instructions for demonstration purpose. So in this video, so already I have discussed about the things like what is area, and next is name, then we have something like code and read only. So here I am discussing few data transfer and data processing instructions. So under that, initially I have declared few variables with some constant and as well as equated values. So just to note down these values, what is variable 1, 2, 3 and 4, so that once we go to the actual simulation, you can just cross verify there. Okay, so first step is make sure that you don't have any errors. So that is fine now. Then go to debug and click on start. Now this is the memory window. So this is this one I had already opened it, and again I am telling you, once you are in debug mode, you can go to view and you can go to memory window. So if you want to verify 2-3 memory windows, something like in location 1000, 1008, some other location, if the data are being processed in different memory locations, you can click on this. You will get another memory location, and there you can type the required address. So you will get two memory locations, or parallelly four memory locations side by side. So now let me go to the required steps. Okay, now we are in the main program. So first, initially R0, R1 and R2 and sorry R5 and R4 will be loaded with the above mentioned values and their memory contents if they have some values. So again, just note down these values. So if I execute now, R0 is loaded with variable 1, which is this value. So if you go to this here, you can check the value here, right? Now similarly, if you click on the next one, R1 will be loaded with variable 2, that is this one. And now we can see some surprise here. What is the value here? 208. And just check here what will be loaded in R5. So in R5 you are getting 200. Why? So in order to check that, let us go to this location, 208. So if you go to this location now, if you see these red colored values, so these red colored values are actually being loaded. These values are now being loaded because of the link register or the program counter. So next, now if you consider the same thing for variable 4, for this instruction, so R4 is loaded with what value? The variable 4, because that address may not be readable. So the previous address which we had loaded, that is 208, which was readable, hence the value is being loaded here, right? Now if you consider the next instruction, what we have here is STMIA, that is store multiple and increment after. So if you consider this, so since we have not used that exclamation mark here, R8 value will not be updated here, so this will remain zero only. But what will be or what should be stored in the memory location pointed by R0 to R3. So if you consider this R0 to R3, so we need to have the R8 as the source here and R0 to, so as you can see here, we need to execute this now, right? So if you execute this, so let us check what, which all changes will happen across R0 to R3. So R8 is having this value because we know this value is there, and R0 is loaded with what value? It is 200. So let us see that memory location. R1 with this location, so if I go to memory window, I can use another memory window here, and I can use the R1 value, that is 100 this location. So like that you can also load the other two locations also, so R4 and this one, right? So now if I execute this instruction, so let us check what we are getting. So R8 is not having any value, so check now what is, or do you find any change here? Since R8 is not having any value, so R0 to R3, those addresses, content of R8, if you take R0 to R3, so R0, what is the value there? So it is now, is it unchanged? So that you have to observe here, right? So are these values are being loaded? So that you have to check R0. Next, R1 at this location. So check that. No. Now, if I use exclamation mark, now what is the value of the R8 value here now? R8. This R8 is having no value, zero. But if I use this exclamation mark, so what we can expect? So we expect that should again store multiple instruction, multiple data, and it should increment after, right? So how many addresses are there to be updated? R0, R1, R2, R3. So totally we have four registers, the address pointed by four registers. So now if I execute, now you can check that here R8 value is changed from 000002. Now 00000010. Why this is 10? Because 10 in hexadecimal it represents 16. So how many addresses we are pointing? We are pointing the addresses located by, or the address pointed by R0 to R3. Totally 32 values. So for each value, for each 8 bit values, it requires 4 locations. So hence 4 into 4 it is 16, right? So 16 means it is now 10 here. And also we can see that whether the R0, R1 and R2 value have been changed or no, right? So we see that only R8 is updated. And if you check these locations, so do you find any changes? So if it is no, then that will be the answer. Otherwise, if you have some data here, then that data will be loaded here. And now, if you execute the next instruction, we have to load R0 with this value, that is loaded here now, as you can see. Then R1 with this value, that is also loaded. Then R2 with this value. Okay. So R1 and now R2 will be loaded now, sorry. So R1 and R2 are having these values. So if you just check out those values, you can make a note of these R1 and R2. Now if I execute this instruction, push R1 hyphen R2 means R1 to R2. If I say R3 means R1, R2, R3. So what has to be pushed? The content of R1 to R2 register. Or if you say R1 to R4 means R1, R2, R3, R4 contents have to be pushed to the stack pointer. And where to get the stack pointer address? So SP is now this value, as you can see this value. But now if I execute this instruction, you can see that SP is updated to a new value. So the new value is 1 followed by 4 zeros and 200, right? Now if I go to that location, what I expect there? 1 followed by 4 zeros, 200. Now you can see here in the location we have these values 1 1 1 1 1 1 2 2 2 2 2 2. So these are nothing but the contents of what? R1 and R2. So first register what you use, so that will be pushed to the address pointed by stack pointer. The current address is this, right? We have these values. Now if I use the another instruction, that is pop. Popping means what? Where the, and also we can check here, earlier this value of SP was 208. Now as we push the data onto the stack, SP value will be decremented. For each push it will be decremented by 4. So we have performed two push, push R1 and R2. It will be decremented by 8. Now if I pop, means it will increment by 4, right? And it will point to the location 204. So I will show that. Now what will happen? The content where the SP is pointing, so it is pointing here. So this value has to be retrieved back to R2. So let us see R2 will get updated or no. So if I execute this, you can see here clearly, first thing, SP is updated to 204, and as well as you can see its location, now it has, the color is changed. These values will appear in R2. Earlier R2 was 22, 22, 22 and 22. So this is how we can execute the stack operation, right? And now if I go to the next instruction, what we have? LDMIA, load multiple and increment after. So if I execute this, we have the this exclamation mark, means the present value of R0 will be updated after performing the load operation. What has to be loaded? This is the destination, this is the source. R1 and R2 content have to be loaded to the address pointed by the starting address, from the starting address pointed by R0. So R0 is currently this value. If I go to this location, so what we have now here, we have some data here, right? Now if I can see here, we have some data, some earlier executed data. Now if I execute this, just keep an eye here and as well as here, what will happen? This will also change. It will change from 204 to which value? 206. And you can see that which values are being loaded, or which values are being loaded. Now at 204 we had this value 00010010. These values are being loaded here 00100010. 10, and also the content of 208 are being updated here to R2, this value, right? So we have these values are being loaded here to R2, and not only that, we can see that this was earlier 200, I guess. So now it is, what is the value? 206, because now it is pointing at this location, increment after load multiple values, then increment the base register. If I don't use this exclamation mark, if you delete this, then it will not show you the incremented value. It will remain at 200 only. Okay. So with different values, please execute these things, then you will understand this clearly. Okay.